And it was only $5, so call the police. This is a steal. Hey guys, it's Avery from A Very Avid Reader, and welcome back to my channel. I'm really excited for today's video because today I'm going to be doing my first book haul. And something special about this haul is that all of the books that I got were either from used bookstores or from thrift stores. So personally, I am a big fan of buying books on a budget. If it's a new book that I'm really excited for, then I will go pick up a new version of it. But other than that, I am pretty much down to have used copies of books. I just don't mind it. I don't think that your books need to be completely pristine unless it's like your favorite book and you want a really nice version of it, then that's totally understandable. But if I see a book that is used and I can get it for a few bucks that I've been wanting to read, then that is just like hitting the jackpot for me. So I've been collecting some of these books for about a few weeks. So some of these came from used bookstores around where I live or around where my parents live, and I even got one from Goodwill. I found some really good stuff. I found some classics, which I'm really excited about, but also some just regular YA and a regular adult. I'm not sure if it's a romance book, but it's like an adult fiction book. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, and without further ado, let's get started. So I'm gonna start off by showing you some of the classics that I got first, and I got five. So the first one I was very excited to see at this local used bookstores, and it is Frankenstein by Mary Shelley. So first of all, look how gorgeous this edition is. It is so pretty, and we have red edges on the book. I love sprayed edges on books. And look at the spine, it's so pretty. And it's like this soft kind of, I'm not sure what it's made out of, but it's kind of this really like soft material, and it's just so pretty. Look at the inside, so cool. Just kind of looks like, you know, human, you know, cells maybe. But it is in really nice condition, and I was really excited to see this, especially because it was only $5. And for a book that is so pretty like this and is in really good condition, I just thought that was a steal. So I was super excited to see this. I read this in high school and I actually really enjoyed it. A lot of the books that we have to read in high school, I feel like kind of suck, but I really liked Frankenstein. I thought it was very interesting, and I don't have my own copy of it, so I was super excited to see this really gorgeous version of it. The next classic that I picked up is Wuthering Heights by Emily Bronte. So I have been wanting to read this. This is on my to-read list in my list of classics that I kind of want to get started with. So I was really excited to see this at my local used bookstore, and it was only $1. So obviously it's not in the best condition. She's definitely been read and she's been used, but I mean, I'm not sure if I'm gonna like it yet. So I thought for $1, it was a really nice, you know, way to pick the book up for the first time. And if I enjoy it, then maybe in the future I'll invest in nicer versions of it. Plus it's so nice and little, so I liked it. The next three books that I have picked up are all plays by Shakespeare. So I found these really cool editions. It looks like they were a Barnes & Noble, like Shakespeare edition, of The Merchant of Venice, Macbeth, and The Taming of the Shrew. So I have read Macbeth before and I really liked it. I think it's probably one of my favorite Shakespeare plays, but I haven't read The Taming of the Shrew or The Merchant of Venice. So I want to read more Shakespeare, like I said, trying to read more classics, and they were super cheap. So I decided to pick these up as well. There were actually two other ones. I can't remember what they were. It might've been King Lear and one other one. But so they do, some of them have annotations and a little bit of highlighting in them, and I'm okay with just a little bit of it, but the other two that they had were like completely highlighted and marked up, and it was kind of crazy. But these were books that the used bookstore was giving away for really cheap, probably because they've been marked up, so they were only like 15 or 20 cents each, so they were super cheap, and they were just these really cool additions, so I thought that they would be a good little find. Okay, so that concludes the classics that I got in my haul. Now let's move on to the YA books that I picked up. The first YA book that I picked up was Scarlet by Marissa Meyer, and this is the second book in the Lunar Chronicles, which I have read and really loved. I read them a few years ago, and if you can see on my shelf, I have Cinder and Winter. And Winter is the last one, I believe. They're not in order either. But I just eventually want to get the whole collection. I believe there's 4 of them. And so this was only, I think, $2 or $3. So yeah, it's a little used, but it's in pretty good condition. So I thought it would, you know, be a good addition to my collection. The next book I picked up was kind of in the same category where I just wanted to finish off a series that I didn't have the last book to, and it is Calamity by Brandon Sanderson. So this is the third and final book in the Reckoners series, and I actually haven't finished the series. I have the first two, which are up there. So the first one is Steelheart and the second one is Firefight, and I read these a while ago, and I remember I really liked them, and I just am not sure why I never finished the series. I don't know if you guys have ever done that, where you read like the first few books in a series and you enjoy them, but like the third one isn't out yet, but when it comes out you just kind of forget to pick it up, and it's not because you didn't want to read it, because you enjoyed the series, you just kind of don't. I've done that with a few series where I liked the first book or I liked the second book, but I just didn't pick up the next one. So I thought it would be good to complete my series, and eventually one day maybe I will read it. But I know that I will need to go back and read the first two before I read the third one, because I remember the series was really good, but it was also complicated, so it's been a while, so I don't think I could just pick up with the third one. So maybe one day I will go in and finish the series, but I am glad to know that now I have the whole thing if I ever want to do that. So the next book that I picked up was A Great and Terrible Beauty by Le Bebre. So I've heard really good things about this series. I can't remember if it's Emma from Emma Books or if it's Hannah from A Clockwork Reader who really loves this series, but I know that it has been very highly recommended by one YouTuber that I really enjoy watching. And the first one was at this used bookstore for only $2, so I thought that it was kind of a steal. It's in really great condition. Yeah, there's really not much wear. Maybe the corners are a tiny bit. And this series is about a girl named Gemma Doyle who is sent to a boarding school after tragedy strikes her family in India. So she's from Britain and she gets sent to a boarding school in London. And it says there that her power to attract the supernatural unfolds while she's at this boarding school. And she also gets involved with this shadowy group called the Order at this school. And yeah, I'm not really 100% sure what else happens, but it sounds like a very interesting premise, so I'm excited to read this one. So that was it for all of my YA books. I have one more book for this haul, and that is Paris by the Book by Liam Callanan. And I actually picked this up at a Goodwill, so it was only about $1. And it's a hardback and is also in pretty great condition. And if you've been watching my channel, you know me, I cannot resist a book that has the word Paris in the title. So when I saw it, I picked it up and read the summary, and it looks really interesting. So it's about this woman, Leah, whose husband vanishes, and he's this eccentric novelist, and so he vanishes and leaves behind tickets for her and her daughters to travel to Paris. Obviously, they're intrigued and want to know what happened to their father and to her husband, so they go to Paris and they start living there, and they are slowly trying to figure out what happened to their dad. It says they trace literary paths of some of the most beloved Parisian classics like Madeleine and The Red Balloon, and they look for clues to figure out where he's gone. So that just sounds really interesting to me. Obviously it has to do with Paris and it has to do with books. It sounds like they're going to be exploring Paris through these classic books that take place in Paris. So I thought that it was really interesting looking, and I picked her up. So those were all the books that I picked up on this thrifting haul. I hope that you enjoyed, and if you've read any of them, let me know what you thought of them in the comments, or if you thought any of them looked interesting, let me know also. Also, leave me a comment below letting me know what treasure or book you found at a used bookstore or thrifting that was just really exciting to find that you got for cheap. So once again, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe if you want to see more videos from me. Thank you so much to the people that have subscribed to me. I really appreciate every single one of you, and I mean, thanks for wanting to watch my channel. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this quick little haul, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!